What's up, everybody? It's Jake here. Becky's here with me. She's moseying up there. But this behind me is an old farmhouse. Let me flip around.
It's a smokehouse that was built in 1815. Here's our farmhouse. I believe this is the Renview farmhouse. They do give tours. Renview Museum and Park. Royer Milk House. And this was built in 1805. Let's go check out the forge. Take a peek. This is built in 1812. It's the farmhouse. We got wavy glass windows. Hard to see in there. Let's look in this window. I have to come back when they're open. I give tours. Another place, very nice inside. We're gonna continue. We're going on a walk. Today there was a reenactment and yesterday. It's ended though, pretty much everybody's gone now. There's a couple people still over there getting packed up. But we're gonna explore the area. We're gonna take a nice little walk. See what else we see here. Probably find a couple neat little things. On this way. So we parked over here, and we followed this up here, look at this. So we gonna go over, check out the rest of these trails. We on the plantation trail. See where it goes. So I just came off of that trail, plantation trail. And now we got a trail that goes this way and that way. Becky's already going that way. That's the way we're gonna go. This is cemetery trail. Check out the corn though. It's pretty cool looking. Goes all the way down that way. And all the way up that way. So I gotta go catch up with Becky. See if we can find a cemetery. I think it's a cemetery down here on the left. So we're gonna take a peek. Get a little bit of video. Alright, we're coming up here in the center of the cornfield. This is the barn we were at earlier. We walked up the other side of the cornfield on the trail over there, then laying down the plantation trail, came over around there, came down this way, and we are now at the cemetery. They have a big rock here with probably a plaque on it that Becky is now reading. We'll take a peek here. This is completely fenced in. Definitely a old cemetery. I'll circle around the other side, get the front of the mall. In the middle of a cornfield, we're surrounded by corn. What's the sign? It's a plaque. Here we go. Graveyard is the grave of John Burns.
1747 to 1802, Pioneer Patriot, Waynesboro area. You guys can pause and read that if you want to read it. I'm gonna go, there is an opening here, so we can go in here. Oh, this part too has these little things here. And if you click that, you can watch a video, a personal tour, or you can just watch my video. But I figured I'd do a little cross promotion there. It's a nice park. Jeremiah Burns. They need to get some filler over here. They got something living down in the grave over here.
It's a rodent hole of some sort. Looks like, yeah, they gotta get somebody in here because they got rodent holes next to some of these graves. I hate when I see that type of stuff. Let's go by a few of these to see if we can read them here.
That's his grave.
I wonder if these ones that are laying down, if they were always laying down. I guess they were. Or they fell over and they concreted them. I don't know. They might have always been concreted in like that. I'm not sure. Anybody have any ideas? Let me know. I'll look it up more when I get home online. But yeah, it looks like it's a marked grave site. But how many? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So about 10 people, maybe. Maybe 10. Thinking about 10 people. So you got two sets of headstones and two sets of footstones. Well, we're gonna continue. We're gonna go down the hill. We're gonna head over to those buildings over there. There's a furnace and maybe some mill ruins. So we're gonna check out that. Going down this way. Yeah. We came from right over there on the left side. See, this is where last night we came up here. Everybody was camping. Yeah.
All was
full of tents. Civil War style. Didn't really get any video because I still can get a little more funding. Get some money set aside. I'm gonna get some lights. But I can get some really good night footage. Plus I wanna get a drone. Drone I think would be a nice add-on to the videos. But yeah, all they're doing now is getting cleaned up around here. People are getting packed up. So we're going up here and check this building out right here. One over around the side, we're gonna check out where the furnace is. We're doing it. Got a garden over here next to this other building. Please close the gate.
Yeah.
They don't want the deer getting in here. Hopefully bunny rabbits don't get in here, because they'd be eating some of this stuff too. Look at that. Tomatoes. A lot of butterflies flying under here. Bugs are eating these. All right, let's continue. And we looked at everything in this garden. We just left the garden. Going down this building right here. What is this?
Fernstock Farmstead.
House built in 1808. Barn was built in 1815. So that's the barn up there. So this is a smaller house on the property. Look at these doors. Are these open? Can I look in here?
Nope.
They're locked from the inside. Thought you could peek through a window. What's this fence all about? Oh, there's a little, there's a staircase. Okay. Seems to be a trail that goes that way. We're going down here. Well, this is probably a well or where an outhouse might have sat. I don't know exactly what it's been. It's a little thing on there. This is probably a cellar of some sort. They don't got any windows you can look in. This place is like boarded up like Fort Knox. Let's see what's over this fence. Another foundation down here. I have to check this area out. We'll go check out the furnace and then we'll go down there. Anything over here? No. Yep, so we're gonna go back around. We're gonna go that way and try to search. I think the furnace is right. I zoom in, you can kind of see. Yeah, see that bush is right there. So we're gonna go there, and then we're gonna try to go down and around. So let's hope we can do this. I got some firewood. Really neat though. I like the stonework here. A couple different building materials they used to look like. Mostly this granite. We're going up this way. Site of the limestone kiln, 1799. Gonna walk this little trail right here. Oh, I see it. Oh, spiders. There's a lot of spiders out in this area. Looks like we have to go up to go around. The additional stone for this project. This has been redone. Some of its original. Some's been reworked. Yeah, you can definitely tell the cement in between is really fine cement. This is kind of cool how I made a little walkway into here. And we're in the furnace. A little slicey looking rock. Has it got words in here? It kind of looks like it says something.
ER.
It's cool looking. I don't know what that exactly is. I didn't see anything about that, but there's definitely whoever redid this.
R-O-Y-E-R, Royer. That's their name.
Oh, Royer. That is really cool. I'll have to get a picture of that. Alright, we're going to go out here, and we're going to go up, out this way, and up to the top of this. Take a peek from the top, up near that fence right there. Ready? Three. Two, one. Pretty cool. Pretty cool. All right, we gotta go down the hill now. See what we can find down below.
Down there. Way that way. Down there. right back over that one building right before we went to the furnace, and going down this way. There's a few more, might be a few more things to check out down here. So this is the path we decided to take. This is a big loop basically we're doing here. Gonna end up back at the parking lot we originally were at. Oh man, some grinding stones down here. Millstones. This is neat. This is a lot of millstones all in one spot. I don't know if I've seen this many. Oh, there's a foundation down there. That's a foundation to, I guess, the mill. That's probably the mill foundation. You have the back half here. This is probably where the water ran through, possibly. I'd rather go down and look. But check these stones out. And these are millstones, and there would be two of them, and the grain would go between them. See, this would help break up the grain. Now, I don't know if the metal pieces are original, or they just added them to keep them anchored down. Like this one's got a... That might be part of it. This has like metal studs of some sort. They were cut off though. You can see they're kind of like melted. This one's kind of weird. I don't think I've seen one like this. Yeah, I wouldn't believe they would all be from the same place. This is too many of them. Yeah, there's a plaque here. That one kind of looks like a Reese's peanut butter cup. I'm gonna walk down to the furnace. Oh, what's that say? Not the furnace. So this was here, put here in 2013. This is really neat though. I haven't seen so many millstones all in one spot before in my life, I don't believe. There's a mill race trail. Really nice trails here. We're going to end up going across that bridge, I believe, to go continuing the way we need to go. Here we go. So this was the mill, grist mill. Royer. Not much left, but significant enough to see. So you can clearly notice there was something here. Looks like it had a couple different spots here. That was brick and this was stone. Let's travel into the facility. Might have had this is either concrete floor or just debris from when they collapsed. No, it looks like it's concrete at the bottom. There's some more debris over there with some moss growing on it. This is like a little marshy area, so this might have been like... See, there's a spot right there, arch. There's an arch right there, I don't know if you guys can see it. So I'm taking it this might have been an area where they channeled water. It even looks like there's water in there right now. See, there might be another arch right there. It's hard to tell. This has got so much dirt in here. This is probably empty at one time. It's probably lower than this side. And the water probably channeled through here. That's what I'm thinking. I could be wrong. But my main reason behind that is there is water in here. There's a puddle of water under there. I don't know how deep it is. It's definitely got an archway here, so the water could go this way, and the other archways kind of see it. Becky's on the bridge.
I'm gonna go over there. There's another trail that goes this way. I think we're gonna save that for another trip out here, because this ain't too far from our new place. Not too far, about an hour drive. What is that one called? Trail Race Trail. That was a trail race for the mill. So it probably went that way. Pretty cool. That's some interesting trees here. Look at that tree. It's Wampa. Nice bridge. But yeah, we continue across this bridge right here. Little picnic area over there. I'm gonna keep walking straight this way, following the trail. It should take us back toward our car. I don't know if there's anything else, but we'll keep an eye out. Stay right here. Walking with us, hiking the trail. Yeah. We came to a split in the trail. And there's a nice little river overlook area. Not really overlook, but we got a nice view of the river. These are all like the gunpowder packages. When they had the Civil War battle. I think we want to go this way. See different ways we can go. Well, let's go this way and see what happens. Stay next to the river. Yeah, river time. River walk. We're walking back. Still walking this trail. Might almost be
done. We're back at the car. I think this is probably the end. So remember, like, share, and subscribe. Share the video. You know anybody wants to come here? Show them the video. It's a pretty nice place. All right, peace everyone. Till next time.